Hello, and welcome to another video in this TI Precision Labs series on magnetic position sensing. My name is Ian Williams, and I'm the Applications Manager of the Current and Magnetic Sensing product line. In Session 2 of the Getting Started with Hall Effect Sensors series, my colleague introduced three kinds of Hall Effect sensors and the difference in operation for each one. TI offers two kinds of linear Hall Effect sensors, linear voltage output type, and PWM output type with varying duty cycle. In this video, I'm going to discuss some key specifications of these linear Hall Effect sensors. Linear Hall Effect sensors with analog voltage output generate a ratio metric voltage between 0 volts and VCC that is proportional to the magnetic flux density present. For a bipolar device, such as DRV5055, when there is no magnetic flux present, the device output is equal to VCC over 2. This is also known as the quiescent voltage, VQ. Based on the strength and polarity of the magnetic field present, the device outputs voltages that are either above or below the quiescent voltage. This type of device lends itself well to applications such as the one shown on the right, where a magnet moves right and left over the Hall sensor. For a unipolar device, the quiescent voltage is equal to some low but non-zero voltage. For the DRV5056, VQ is typically equal to 0.6 volts. Unipolar devices are sensitive to only one polarity of magnetic field, usually the south pole, and the output voltage increases from VQ as the magnetic flux density increases. This type of device lends itself well to applications such as the one shown on the right, where a magnet moves up and down from directly above the Hall sensor. Linear Hall sensors that have a PWM output, such as the DRV5057, output a 2 kHz clock with variable duty cycle. When there is no magnetic flux present, the duty cycle is 50%. The duty cycle increases or decreases proportionally with the strength of magnetic flux density applied. Before we can explain the relationship between sensitivity and sensing range, first we need to define them. Sensitivity is basically gain. For example, the DRV5055 family has four sensitivity or gain options, ranging from 12.5 to 100 millivolts per millitesla. The symbol BL describes the linear sensing range of the magnetic flux density. The blue line shows the output behavior of DRV5055A1, with a sensitivity of 100 millivolts per millitesla and a linear sensing range of plus or minus 21 millitesla. The orange line shows the output behavior of DRV5055A3 with a sensitivity of 25 millivolts per millitesla and a linear sensing range of plus or minus 85 millitesla. For a given application, the system designer should select the highest sensitivity option that can measure the required range. This will allow them to get maximum voltage output per millitesla measured. Accuracy is greatly affected by tolerances in two key parameters, quiescent voltage and sensitivity. The min and max values listed in the datasheet are an indication of device-to-device variations. The tighter this min-max range is, the higher the accuracy of the device. In some high-accuracy applications, a one-time end-of-line calibration can be used to reduce the effect of tolerances in these parameters. In general, magnets produce weaker fields as temperature increases. The DRV505X family includes temperature compensation, which is designed to fully compensate for the average drift of neodymium magnets and partially compensate for ferrite magnets. The residual induction, BR, of a magnet typically reduces by 0.12% per degree C for neodymium magnets and 0.2% per degree C for ferrite magnets. For more information and videos on Hall effect sensors, please visit ti.com/halleffect. Thank you.